everybody, James here from Beaver Does Podcast. We're here for another Daily Room review. And today we are doing a movie that was just released today. The Conjuring, The Devil Made Me Do It, directed by Michael Chives. It is in the Conjuring universe. What do you think to the Conjuring universe? If you have an opinion on the Conjuring universe, please throw a message below. I feel Annabelle started off not very good and it got better. The Nun wasn't good at all. And from what I watched through this movie, the Conjuring, the mainline universe, is getting bad. So this is based on a true story. Paranormal investigators Ed and Lorraine Warren take on one of the most sensational cases of their career after a cop stumbles upon a dazed and bloody young man walking down the road. Accused of murder, the suspect claims demonic possession as his defense, forcing the Warrens into a supernatural inquiry unlike anything they've ever seen before. Now, my opinion on this movie is this movie had, in my opinion, a really strong opening, and then everything else in this movie just got worse and worse. It got so slow and so boring, in my opinion, that I was falling out of it. That opening with the exorcism of the small child was so good. It's in all the trailers. And then everything else is a police investigation. I was almost getting ready for them to do a whole court case about this, and that would be the whole movie. But instead, it's like they tried to shoehorn an investigation. And it kind of got a bit interesting towards the end. I liked some aspects of it. But in my opinion, after the first two, which were really good, and then some like decent scares, and then this one, it kind of, it's directed by the guy who did The Curse of La Llorona, and that I wasn't a fan of that one either. And it seems like it's kind of the same with this. And the issue now is we're starting to get to a point where they're telling the best stories. And even though they do have technically their best stories, the movies aren't that good. The Nun should have been great, like the whole tie together and everything, but it ended up just being, in my opinion, boring. And then this, which is based on a true crime case, and I usually love like stuff like this, but how they made it super boring, in my opinion. And that's something you don't do in horror. There was some things here or there that I really enjoyed. Like I said, that opening scene, the opening exorcism, I love that. And I would have liked to have seen something very similar to that, but with like a bit more investigative. But it just turned out that this movie just really disappointed me. There's been a bit of a long wait between the other two movies, and it suffers, in my opinion. It suffers. And I think one of the main reasons why the first two were good was you had James Wan, who is a fantastic director, involved. And since he's passed the reins on and only has like a producer role, the movies have gotten weaker. And I don't know where they go from here. They've tried to do this whole movie franchise, like this whole Conjuring universe, and it's fallen flat all throughout. So if it was up to me, I would like to see this as kind of being the end of the Conjuring universe. I think they've hit a wall. Same with Insidious, both those movies. The only thing really is that I would actually want to see, but then I'm kind of afraid, was they're still promising a Crooked Man movie. And if it's going to be anything like this or anything like The Nun, I don't want it, because when he featured in the second one, he was an amazing looking monster. But then everything else is a shame. So even though I've kind of been, the acting was good, had some great actors in it. Vera Farmiga and Patrick Wilson, and even one of my favorite actors, he's amazing. he's amazing. He recently was in The Boys. He's been in Lord of the Rings. He's in Fringe, John Noble. He plays a prominent role in this, and he's amazing. The acting really pushed this up when the story was weak. And even then, the story should have been strong considering what went on in this movie. But just some bad direction and some bad choices really put it down for me. So it went, the start of the movie, I was like, okay, this is a 4. Then as the movie went on, it's just gone down and down. And towards the middle, I had this as a 1. But then from there, towards the end, with some of the acting choices and some of the stylistic choices, it became a mediocre movie. This is a 2 blanks movie. What did you think if you've seen this? It's available on HBO Max or video on demand. If you want to check it out and give me your thoughts, like, comment, and subscribe. Also, if you want to check out daily reviews, tune in tomorrow. I'm going to participate in the Game of Death. Later, guys.